We are coming to you live from Los Scandalous Shake and Bake Arena, and the A-listers are out tonight. You can feel the electricity in the air.
Feel it? There's an electrical storm. Look, a boat just took out their mascot. Lightning blasts all over the place, Grim. This is dangerous.
And danger is what this league is all about, Bricks. And the fans, they're loving it. Pain, suffering, humiliation, and possibly a conga line. This game's gonna have it all. A Gnashville Lycans battle. The Los Scandalous Volts. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. The paddy wagons in the parking lots are full. The familiar scent of bodily fluids in the air. And the men's room is both flooding and on fire. And that means MFL Game Day is on the air. Hi, everyone. Grim Blitzer along with Bricks and Bricks Jr.
Man, last week some mutant let out a lava blast in one of the stalls in the men's room. Place went up like an oil rig. Flames and explosions. Water shooting out of where the toilets were. I electrocuted myself using the electric hair dryer. I wish they had paper towels at least as an option.
Oh, what a punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size. Because he just walked all over him. And it's first and 10. And the QB might as well just bury himself now because this guy's full up. And the quarterback calls a sonic blast dirty trick and throws a super...
Oh, sure, now he catches it. I had this guy on my fantasy team last week. I lost so much money on him, not to mention my kneecaps. My loan shark is very anal about collecting my money on time, Grim.
And it's first and 10. And they line up for the extra point. It's good. The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. First and 10. And that's the way to get the sticks moving. He picks up 5 yards on that play. Second down and 5. Looks like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
It sounds like my off season.
And it's first and 10. He dropped it. If he does that again, they'll drop him. Second down and 10. And he gets 3 yards on that run. And that'll bring up 3rd down and 7. And the ball razors through the defense, cutting a defender in half. Nicely done for a first down. Yeah. It's first and 10. And he just bristles away from that tackle. Nice pickup for 6 yards. And that'll be second down and 4. Third down and 6. Oh, and did he just put on a display there? Touchdown! Comes the extra point attempt. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
That hit's gonna shave a few days off his life. And it's first and 10. Second down and a lock. Third down, and the punter is warming up. Maybe the QB should throw it and catch it too. Boring, but smart. Time to punt.
Whoa, whoa, you can't say that on the radio.
Rainbow. The return man. Oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I'll bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after 3, Grim, but my watch is a bit slow.
Oh, devastating hit. You ever get hit that hard, Bricks?
Yep. Third grade. Sister Mary Margaret of Our Ladies of Holy Hell. Knuckles, but it was just a regular knuckles.
And they stack the line, and he gets his bell rung for a yard. Second down and 9. Oh, with a punishing hit. Third down and a sliver. And that's how you run the football. First down. And it's first and 10. When it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made at the dice, Grim. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth. Is the game over yet? I gotta go to the vet to have them reattach my big toe to where my thumb was again. It just fell off for the third time today. I was barely even chewing on it.
No. teams are all tied up at the end of quarter one. We'll be right back. Well, they couldn't pick up a first down, so now they have to punt. A misfired punt will give the opposing team. He's got the ball now. Let's see what he does with it.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
And it's first and 10. Great run for a 9-yard gain. And that'll bring up second and 1. He had nowhere to go and got nothing out of it. Bring up third and 1. One potato, two potato, three potato, four. The defense just blew up a player who thought he was going to score. Oh, that hot potato dirty trick gets him every time. And it's first and 10. It's a first down from a great catch.
Was it a catch, though? Let's consult at least 72 pages of rules to figure it out.
And it's first and 10. Remember, folks, in the MFL, you are allowed to touch the quarterback just like that. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. He's rumbling and stumbling. He could go all the way. Oh, and the quarterback threads the needle for a first down. And it's first and 10. Pick up 9 with that catch.
Not enough for first, but still a nice game.
And that'll bring up second and 1. And he runs into the end zone for a touchdown.
See that move, baby? I'm the greatest. No, you didn't see that.
Should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. Straight through the uprights. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. He sets up for the return. Let's see if he can break one wide open. Sticky ball, dirty trick. The only thing the QB can do now is run for his life.
Or die.
Second down and more than the QB would like. Exploded.
Yeah.
Second down and a... And the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner. He took a beast boost injection. Now watch him stomp all over his opponents.
I wanna take a beast boost injection too!
Now that has weird side effects, Bricks. And they needed that big run right there, Bricks.
They sure fucking did, Grin. They sure fucking did.
Third down and forever. It's called a zap attack. The ball carrier. Oh, welcome to Fumbletown, USA. Population, this guy. Well, he should be more careful when he hurdles. Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned out the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chimp wearing a wig.
It's the two-minute warning. You know what that means?
Whiskey?
And it's first and ten. That's a gain of 10 yards. And they stop the clock with their first time out to try and stay in this game.
Oh, nice coaching move there. Hall of Fame caliber.
Well, I mean, it's a pretty standard coaching move at this point of the game.
I won't listen to this blasphemy!
Oh, with the brain scrambler! They've got one more timeout left, but they've stopped the clock.
Why don't they just take the batteries out of the clock, Grim? That would make more sense!
And it's first and ten. About a 6-yard gain.
Hey, do me a favor. If my parole officer calls, I was with you last night, Bricks.
No problem. I spent the night in lockup for solicitation.
And that's the last time out. They can't stop the clock anymore.
Can any of us really stop the clock, Grim? I mean, when it comes right down to it, are we not all united by the constant reminder of our own mortality? Of death's constant, relentless advance? If only it was as easy as telling them, time out, to stop our own clock.
That's a killer. It was right there, and then he dropped it.
Oh, scumbag is killing me in the fantasy game.
Third and four. He had it for a second there. The kicker should make this, but you know how it goes in this league. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. First and ten. leaving them with two in case they need them.
Yeah, just like condoms, hatchets, and wives, huh, Grim?
You know, you just summed up why we don't get together outside of work, Bricks.
Pow! With the brain scrambler! Well, that's two timeouts burned, and you have to wonder, Bricks, are they desperate or are they in control?
Yeah, I'm speaking from experience, Grim, but it really is hard to do both at the same time. And I have mastered it.
And he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
And that's the end of the second quarter. Someone will need to pull together some bribe money as they head to their lockers. Stay with us for the halftime show, brought to you by our friends at Monsatan Industries. We make genetically altered frankenfood you'll have fun trying to identify. The teams line up for the kickoff to start the second half. These guys will have to play a lot harder to make it a game. Well, either that or kill and cheat more. Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. That, my friends, was an all-pro MFL hit. And it's first and ten.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
He sends it in there for a 4-yard gain. Second down and six. First and ten. Second down and a lot. Come on, man. You gotta catch that.
I don't catch anything, Grim. I'm retired.
Third down and, well, good luck. A big hit. Hey, Bricks, I'll bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after three, Grim, but my watch is a bit slow.
They get ready for the kick. This isn't a gimme. He is automatic. Nice kick.
Boring. Just give him the points and let's move on.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. Just catch it, run it back, and don't die. And it's first and ten. Offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. Hopefully the next guy learns or we're gonna have a pile of dead refs. First down in a mile. Kaboom! And the quarterback on lead. And that is a big gain. You know the defense wants some payback after that. Second down and seven. wants a pass that went nowhere.
Oh, that's like me at the hotel bar every night.
Hey, maybe you need a better opening line then. You want to see the teeth grown out of the roof of my mouth?
What? The book How to Pick Up Girls and Tell Them Something Unique About Yourself. That's unique.
Talk about Butterfingers. He should have had that one. Don't do anything stupid here. Just punt the damn ball and play defense. Nice punt. Should move him back nicely. And he's got a chance for a good return here. Oh, great tackle. When his brain is unscrambled, he'll be thinking about that hit.
Yeah, most likely in a convalescent home.
And it's first and 10. Of about 3 on that play. Second down and 7. He supercharged and devastating hit knocks the ball loose. The defense just won. And he finds open space. He's running toward the end zone.
Turn on your jets, you son of a bitch. You know, letting these dogs into the league is a slippery slope, Grim. First them, then vampires, then mermaids. Then before you know it, we're letting in cat girls. You know, things really start to get weird at that point.
Should be easy, but with kickers, you never know. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
First and 10. That's a 6-yard gain. And that'll be second down and 4. And these guys are not giving the quarterback many passing lanes to hit a receiver. Nice block by the defense there. Third and 4. Oh, a great catch, and he picks up a new set of downs. And it's first and 10. Second down and long. QB is saying his prayers. This guy's gonna get mugged in the locker room by his team after the game. And out comes the most underrated position in football, the mighty punter. And he got it off. That's a decent punt. Nice catch, and he turns on the afterburners. Punt returners in this league have a life expectancy of 3.
One time, when I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the line.
Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the paramedics waving fingers in my face.
And this guy's running like an old guy looking for a bathroom. First down. And it's first and ten. And that brings us to the end of the third quarter. They'll need to fire on all cylinders to make a comeback in the final quarter. And it's first and ten. Catch the ball, get the first down, and don't die. See, it's really a simple game when it comes down to it. And it's first and ten. Second down in a very lot. And into the end zone for a touchdown. Once he got his hands on that pass, he was off to the races. And they line up for the extra point. It's good. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. My turn up.
Oh, and the defender knocked the ball out when he was in midair. It is a fumble indeed.
Fumblemanji, the new game from Wilton Crabtree.
When in a hurry-up offense, the offense needs to run out of bounds or take a timeout to stop the clock. The quarterback passes the ball and it rebounds.
Ouch! What is this, 80s wrestling?
Somehow and hold on for the first down.
This guy has a nice set of hands, Grim. It's the third set of hands he's had shown on today. Looks like it's a good fit.
And it's first and ten. And he held on to that one for a first down. First and ten. And the quarterback drills one in for the first down. And the quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense and calls all the plays from the line of scrimmage from here on out. And he just nailed him right on the numbers for a touchdown. They're going for 2 points. And he makes the grab and adds 2 points to their score. Thank you. for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
And it's first and ten.
Something's not right.
Second down and 10. Oh, he's going berserk. The ball carrier better watch out, because if he gets hit, he is boom, and he's dead. First and 10. Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. He sets up for the return. Let's see if he can break one wide open. Was a bone crusher right there, folks. And it's first and 10. The offense is pretty much unstoppable when they use their beast boost injection. Close your eyes, Bricks. This is gonna get ugly fast. Opens up for them and allows the passing game to be more of a threat. Gotta keep them guessing. The offense goes into their two-minute drill.
What the hell is that?
It's the same thing as a hurry-up offense, you moron.
And he reels that one in for a first down to keep the drive alive. Down and 6.
Yo, seriously, man, you think you'll go toe-to-toe with me? I will wreck your world. You understand me, Junior? I'll wreck your world.
Second down and more than the QB would like. And he put on the afterburners after that catch and scored. Nicely done! Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sitters then.
Straight through the uprights. When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
Man, what a hit that was. First and 10. And he sticks his fingers in the defender's eyes, netting him a pickup of about 8 on the play. The defense calls their first timeout to save some clock.
I save clocks too, Grim. My wife hates them. They take up the whole garage.
Wait, what, you're married?
It's complicated.
And he'll pick up the first down with a nice piece of running there. And the D takes their second timeout, hoping for a miracle.
I witnessed a miracle once. A player was brought back from the dead.
That's not a miracle, partner. That's just how the MFL works. Oh, man, he just laid the wood on that guy.
Yeah, if you're going to hit a guy that hard, you should at least kill.
The defense takes its final timeout. They can't stop the clock anymore, so they'll need to stop the offense. And that'll be second down and 4. First and 10. Oh, what a brutal hit! And it's first and 10. Second down and long. Oh, big catch, big run, big touchdown.
Yeah, big deal. Missed a beat for Braves, ran with a ball, didn't fall down.
Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. Offense goes into their 2-minute drill.
Which coincidentally happens to be Brick's match stupsing time.
That's why the girls call me Speedy Gun.
Oh, a great catch, and he picks up a new set of downs. The Bolts electrify the opposition and come away with a victory. After a stuffing like that, the opposition may be a permanent part of the field.
More like a graveyard, Grim. There are body parts everywhere, and speaking of body parts, did I ever tell
you
about...
Let's listen to EVP. I'm sure he has something inspiring to say.
Hey, man,
Grim Blitzro with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. and all the folks at Evil SN want to thank you for watching this presentation of the Mutant Football League.
Today's game was brought to you by the